In this video, I will be talking about the Playing with Power NES Classics hardcover book. I got this book yesterday and I already devoured its content to its fullest. Man, do I love the NES. I was there back with my NES in the 80s. Yes, I am an 80s kid. Those were the days, man. Just dialing my wood grain TV, searching for the right signal for my RF adapter. According to this book, I am an NES person from the middle period, somewhere between 87 and 89. I remember my first game, which was Airwolf. I was a huge fan of the TV series, and looking back at it, I'm going to say, the memories are better safe in my head. Later on, I got better games like Super Mario Bros. 2 and Beyond a Commando. But back to the book. Let's talk about the outside first. It looks fantastic. If you ever held an NES cartridge in your hand, this is just a sight to behold. Even the back is a copy from an original NES cartridge with the same text. Some of the parts are ripped, like the original cartridge, and the bottom shows the chip card. Of course, that isn't real. On the side you have the book title, and on the other side you have the book itself. Pulling it out reveals another visual gem. Clean and sophisticated. Now the book has 320 pages. That may sound like a lot to chew on, but I can show you how to finish this book in like half an hour. I'm not very keen on the page quality though. I know it's hard to cram 320 paper pages to a respectable size, but this feels like magazine paper. Not that shabby, but you have to be very careful not to tear it by accident. What stood out for me the most were the foreword and personal stories of Don James, Executive Vice President of Nintendo America. There's a funny story about how Nintendo America was built and worth a read. Then there's the writer of the book, Nick von S. Marsh, with his personal story. I say writer because a lot of the content in the book is blatantly copied from other source material. From the minute you start reading, Nick explains in side note that his content originally appeared in other magazines and are just reposts. That doesn't count as writing, Nick. It is fun though, reading old articles, and it's a nice reminder of why we love the NES so much. There's even an old interview with Shigeru Miyamoto about Super Mario Bros. 3, one of the best NES games ever made. Really good stuff if you're into that. But that can't be 320 pages long, right? No. Almost the whole book is a sum up from NES information about games. And they are straight off from the boxes and manuals. Nick also writes out complete manuals on NES classics like the Super Mario and other black box titles. Great if you're into that kind of stuff. To me, it kind of feels like filler content. But the content itself is richly detailed, and if you are going to play that specific game, this is much easier to have on your lap to check for information than a YouTube video. The book ends with a small showcase on NES peripherals. Really funny stuff. I didn't know about the existence of the NES satellite or the hands-free controller. Would I recommend this NES collective book to you? Overwhelming yes, but with a side note. The manufacturer's retail price for this book is a whopping $50. That is a hefty price to pay. I paid only $10 for this book on a sale, and for that price, it is an absolute steal.